real world relationships. Now you spoke something I caught from the 4Ds was dysfunction.
Yes.
And dysfunction could trickle down to your behavior either sexually or either interpersonal sort of skills, real sort of world relationships. Do you recommend these either patients or people that are inflicted or people that find their outlet in pornography and the people that go to that to find any form of affection? Is it a solution to go towards real world relationships? I know you told me that we are now looking at isolating ourselves.
Yes.
The society is more prone to isolation.
Mm-hmm.
Is the solution to go back to people? Is the solution, I'm just suggesting, is the solution to go and create these interpersonal relationships again to understand one another better? Or should, like, I think sex education is one pivotal solution.
Mm-hmm.
But apart from that, is this also another solution that we can look into?
Yes, obviously now, even when it comes to love, let's talk about this. If you talk about love, right, between husband and wife also. Once again, we talk about three concepts. That is this, you know, the theory of love. There is something called theory of love of Robert Sternberg.
Yeah.
And there also we talk about this, you know, the intimacy, and we talk about passion, right, and also commitment. Those are the three aspects also. And which means that, once again, it's just like trying to understand the other person.
Exactly. That is where empathy comes again.
Yes, yes. It does not happen, you know, spontaneously. It should happen, I mean, at the very beginning of one's life, of course. And Sigmund Freud mentioned about this, you know, the superego concept. Superego concept, I mean, that is how we know, how we started the conversation. Superego, it consists of these norms and values and etc. So those things are there. Those things should be there. Otherwise, of course, you know, these impulses would harm someone. So it's there. So this socialization process, in this socialization process, so we need to make people aware of these facts and also how to perceive the other person's perception and how other person's phenomenological world. That is quite important. So my argument is, every time I mention about these things, you are living in a competitive world. It's true. It's true. But on top of everything, be a human being. That's the most important.